A very good morning, class. So yesterday I had messaged you all in WhatsApp that today's session will be related to one of the 2-3 doubts the students were asking me. Many students have messaged me regarding doubts related to index numbers. So there was one sum in exercise 5.3, that is cost of living index number. So there was a mistake in that sum. I'm rectifying that error in this particular video. So there was a mistake done by me and I'm extremely sorry regarding that. So I'll be teaching that sum again. Also, I also got doubts saying that the students were practicing miscellaneous exercise of index number, and in that sum number 8, that is calculate Walsh price index number, they were finding it difficult to remove the square roots because they were not perfect squares. So in today's session class, I'll be teaching you all how to remove the square roots of imperfect numbers, and that too by using log table. So class, pay attention when I'm teaching you all, because it is not compulsory that every time Walsh ka jo index number ka answer aaye, they always be a perfect square. So there are some questions in which the answers may not be, you know, the numbers may not be having the square roots. So today's video is based on that. And as far as the miscellaneous exercise of commission brokerage is left, that video I'll be sending you on Monday. So by Monday, we'll be winding off with commission, brokerage and discount. So you all have to keep practicing, keep learning, keep revising the formulas so that you will remember the concept and rather than by hearting, understand and make it clear. Okay, so first I'm starting with sum number 8, that is Walsh price index number for the following. So this is the question: commodity, base year price, base year quantity, current year price, current year quantity. So pay attention as I'm teaching you all the solution. So here's the solution. This is the question I've copied down. As you all know, students in Walsh, we prepare 4 columns. So here are the columns: Q0, Q1, the second column, square root of Q0, Q1, then P1, root of Q0, Q1, P0, root of Q0, Q1. So now as you all see, for Q0, Q1, we need to multiply both these columns. So 30 into 25 will give you 750. And 42 into 16 will give you 672. Now as you all see, they are not perfect square roots, correct? They are not perfect numbers and they don't have their proper square root. So how did I get 27.38 and 25.92? I'm just gonna show you all. Pay attention. How to solve it by log. So here's the working in front of you. With the help of log table, you can get all the answers without any problem. So now listen to me very carefully when I'm teaching you all the steps. Okay. So now as you can see, we have to find square root of 750 and square root of 672. Now remember class, last year, if you all paid attention when I was teaching you all, the square root is also called as raised to half. So in logarithms, when I say square root, it can also be written as 750 raised to half. So when I tell you all, you can write like this: 750, the whole bracket, raised to half. Half is the index, the power. Okay. Same way, when I talk about 672, it can be written as 672, the whole raised to half. So the same way, when I tell you all cube root, it is 1 upon 3. When I tell you all fourth root, it is 1 upon 4. So that's the logic. Okay. So is the concept clear? Now, second thing, logarithm tells you all that whatever power is there, raised to me. Whatever powers are there, in the form of raised to, after applying log, I can bring them forward. So in the log format, if I write, if I add the word log, it can be written as half log 750. So you have to write like this. That is logarithm ka next formula. So logarithm a raised to m is equal to m log a. So I repeat, logarithm a raised to m is equal to m log a. Basically, जो ऊपर रहता है वो आगे आ जाता है, सामने आ जाता है. So this is the formula in log whatever power is there up, वो आगे आ जाएगा. So this is another basic formula of logarithm. So by using this formula, we'll be solving the sum. So जैसे I told you 750 raised to half, when I apply the log, it becomes half log 750. As you all can see here, I have written. Okay? Then the same pattern I told you, half को अपन कुछ नहीं करेंगे, half उधर का उधर ही रहेगा. The next step is to find out the characteristic and mantissa. So remember class, what did I teach you all? So how to remove the characteristic? There are three numbers. So 3 minus 1, 2 point. Again, there are three numbers. 3 minus 1, 2 point. So dono jagah pe half, half aage aa chuka hai. And 2 point, 2 point. Now we'll remove the mantissa part from the log table. So the logic is 2, 1, 1. But in this case, we have only 2 and 1. So by referring to the log table, we'll see 75 under 0. So here's the log table. And we'll see 75 under 0. So as you all can see, 75 under 0 is 8751. So here goes the page 8751. For the answer. Now you all will see 67 under 2. So while seeing 67 under 2 ka column, you get 8274. So as you can see, I have written 8274. So is the logic clear? How to remove the log and mantissa part from the log table, characteristic and mantissa part. So now you can cancel 2 ones are 0.43755. And here you will get 2 ones are 1.4137. So now here I've got 5 digits, but in log I just require the first 4 digits. So for anti-log part, I will just take 4375 as you all can see here. So I've taken 1.4375, put it in a bracket. I've written the alphabet A plus 1, which you have to do for the decimal. So 1 plus 1, it comes 2. So after, you will get the values from anti-log table like this. It is 43 under 7, mean difference 5. So 43 under 7 from the anti-log table is 2735. Mean difference 5 gives you 3. So it comes to 2738. So decimal after 2 places from the start, answer is 27.38. In the same manner, I have taken 1.4137. Okay. So 41 under 3, mean difference 7. 41 under 3, you will get 2588 from the anti-log table. Mean difference 7, you will find the number 4. On adding, they will give you 2592. 1 plus 1, after 2 decimals from the front, you will put a decimal point here. So the answer is 25.92. So is the working clear? How to remove square roots from the log table? So in this way, you can remove the square root, and then the procedure is very simple. So I've got the values 27.38 and 25.92. Then nothing, you have to multiply these two numbers by P0. You'll get the answer here. And these two numbers again by P1. That is 12 and 20. So you'll get these values. On adding, you'll get the answer. Then after getting the answer, you can total it them and then put Walshka formula like this. P01 of W is equal to summation P1 jaga chodo upon summation P0 jaga chodo into 100. Root of Q0 Q1, root of Q0 Q1. Then substituting the values, as you'll see, I've removed the decimal over here. So after removing the decimal, again I've solved the sum with the help of log table, as you all can see. So the working also I've shown here for your reference. So you all can go through it once and then you all can practice as well. So here's the log working 8469. So 84 under 6, mean difference 9. So there were in all 7 numbers up. तो 7 minus 1 6, 5 numbers down, 5 minus 1 4, so here's the log working 6.4 point. Then 84 under 6, mean difference 9, you'll get the answer 92.79. In the same way for denominator, I have done 47 under 8, mean difference 2. You will get 6796 like this. On subtraction, you'll get 2.2583. 25 under 8, mean difference 3. It gives you 1811 plus 1. The answer is 1812. Then after 2 plus 1, 3 digits, you're putting a decimal point like this. So your answer is 181.3. All right, class. So in this way, you can find the square root with the help of log table. Now, as I told you, there was a sum which was taught wrongly. The last part of the sum, half of the sum was correct. The half part of the sum was wrong. So just pay attention, students. I'm just rectifying the mistake over here, which I had taught you all. Just give me a second. Okay. So here goes the sum. The sum was sum number 9. The cost of living index for the years 95 and 99 are 140 and 200. A person is earning 11,200 per month in the year 1995. What should be the monthly earnings in the year 1999 so that he can maintain the same standard of living? So in this particular sum, the working which I had taught you all was correct. For the base year, it's the logic, the same logic you have to apply. Base year 1995, CLI is given, income is given. So we'll put the formula, real income is equal to income upon CLI into 100. So on solving, we get the answer to be as 8,000. Now for the current year, now from this part, there was a mistake. So please pay attention. So for the current year 1999, CLI is 200. We have to find the income of the person. We already got his real income. So again, we'll put the formula, real income is equal to income upon CLI into 100. So under real income, you have to put 8,000 is equal to income upon 200 into 100. So cross multiply. So 8,000 into 200 divided by 100. You get the answer to be as 16,000. So it was by mistakenly taught by me. The cancellation part was incorrect over there. And the logic we used was also a little bit wrong. So here's the correct pattern of the sum. So just refer to this sum while solving the other sums of the similar nature. Okay, class. So with this, I'll stop the session here for today. So like this, you solve the sum. If you have the doubts, please let me know so that I can also know that you all are practicing and understanding what is going on. All right. So thank you so much, students. And very, I liked it that you all are sharing your doubts with me and clearing them as well. So keep learning, keep practicing, stay safe and stay healthy. All right. Thank you so much, class. So we'll meet next on Monday. On Monday, I'll be sending the videos related to the miscellaneous exercise of commission, brokerage and discount. Okay. So we stop here for today.